Hey guys, this is Parker from Animoplex.com, and I'm here to show you a new freebie called Kinetic Flame for After Effects CS5 or later. Now this was designed to be an easy-to-use rig for animating abstract flame and fire effects, and as you can see, it resembles some sort of magical fire wisp that's very energetic. Now the only requirements for using this template is, you must work in 32-bit color mode for the flame to render, and you must have Trapcode Particular 2.0 or later installed on After Effects CS5. I'm going to give you a quick overview and then let you go experiment to your heart's content. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is open up the After Effects template. With After Effects, I have CC14 here. Now, once it's open, you'll notice there's a single composition and two solids, so it's pretty simple. Now, there's a controller layer at the top of the composition. Now, this is the backbone of the rig, and it controls all the settings for how the flame interacts with your scene. Below that, you have two other important elements. One is the flame source, which is a light object, and it needs to have the first word, flame. You'll notice if you change it to something else, the flame disappears. And that's because the controller is looking for a light object with the first word, flame. The other important element is the two particular layers, and this contains all the particular effects for the flame. You can have more than one light object in this scene, but just know that any changes made to the original light source layer, in terms of velocity, will affect the second layer. So if this light stops, this was the original, this one will stop emitting particles because of it, even if it's still moving. Now the way to fix this is to set all four of these speed effect properties to zero, and basically this changes these lights to constant emission, and now they can be moved independently with different velocities and it doesn't matter. On the controller layer, the first slider here, speed display, is to display the current velocity of your light object. You can keyframe the light object position directly or parent it to another layer like I've done here. Other settings on the controller layer reference this value, and it's not meant to be keyframed, hence the title display. Now the four speed effect properties here allow you to choose if you want the number of particles emitted to be based on the light object's velocity or constant emission or a mixture in between. So here I've set all of them to 50%. It's blending halfway between velocity driven and constant emission. So you can play with these and see what effect you like. Now, particle density is just the number of particles emitted per second. So by default, it's 150. I'm going to change it to 300, and you'll see twice as many particles here. Flame size also dictates the size of each of these particles. Now, you'll notice they just got much larger. You can also change the ember size and the dust size as well. But that's kind of crazy, so I'm going to undo that. The four color settings here are pretty self-explanatory, so you can choose any color you'd like here. Now keep in mind, on top of these color selections, it's going to randomize them by another 30% to make the particles seem a little bit more alive. You get a little bit more variance in there. Now the brightness setting is meant to just boost the brightness value. This is going to be really useful on lighter backgrounds. And finally, the four turbulence effects here control how turbulent the flame, smoke, and embers appear after emission. You can increase or decrease this rig size simply by changing the solid layer size from 1920 by 1080 to any size you'd like. The rig will scale and contract to any size, although you may need to manually scale the size settings and probably the particle density accordingly to avoid extremely small or large flame sizes. Now, one last note, if the controller layer is removed or renamed, in this case I'm just going to delete it out of the composition, each property will revert to a default setting until the layer is restored. This is to avoid expression errors in your composition and can easily be fixed with an undo. Inspiration for this flame effect comes from a project called Particular Nebula by Matrunks, and it's a really interesting effect. I've spent a lot of time working with it and creating this template. I've attempted to streamline the process based on my own uses and make it a really fast render as well. I hope this template is exactly what you were looking for and it inspires you to build something beautiful and unique. If you've created something with it or have any questions at all, please leave me a comment or email me support@animoplex.com and I'd love to take a look. If you're interested in a pre-built logo animation using this effect, I've got a template available for purchase and you can find the links below. It has pre-rendered effects, no need for plugins, but an optional project file with plugins is available if you want to customize it. As always, thanks for watching.